Check 1 2, check 1 2. Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Block Sports. Today, we were scheduled to come on earlier, much earlier, as a matter of fact, about an hour and a half ago. But, I'm sorry, almost 30 minutes ago. But what has transpired is that now we are planning on bringing you the Kentucky State Thoroughbreds versus the Kentucky Wesleyan Panthers live, and we will be filming. Unfortunately, we will only have one camera set up for you to watch today, but we will at least be able to bring to you the game live, and it will be shown right here on yourstreet.tv. So if you are interested in watching the game, please pass this on. Make sure that you tell your friends and neighbors to watch the game live right here on yourstreet.tv. I will be right back. I just want to come and let you know that the game will be shown live.
Yeah. Here come the mighty marching thoroughbreds. Thank you.
this day would like to say a special welcome to all the women of the city of Franklin. We are delighted to have you here to celebrate with us, and we'd like to thank you for taking care of our community. Enjoy the day. Today we have Kentucky State Thoroughbreds taking on Kentucky Wesleyans Panthers for our 2021 home opener. Welcome to the hill, as I used to call it, and I still will, the thrill up on that hill. Kentucky State would like to say a special welcome to all their alumni, community, and friends. We want to direct our attention to the end zone near the field house as we give a first responders, healthcare workers, and members of the United States Department of Health. Please stand up, give them a hand. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for a moment of silence in memory of the 20th anniversary of 9/11, followed by a presentation in color. The pledge is you marching band. Then remain standing for the pledge of lift every voice and sing. Now the playing of our national anthem. Thank you. Please remain standing for the playing of Lift Every Voice and Sing.
Well, good afternoon, folks, and welcome to the Kentucky State, Kentucky Wesleyan game here today. We were expecting to just do a pregame show, but found out that we had the opportunity to do the full game. And we will be bringing this game to you live right here on yourstreet.tv. And we want to welcome all of the fans for KSU. And hopefully you'll get a chance to enjoy the game. The lights are bright, so I don't know how well you'll be able to see the scoreboard here when we bring it up. But unfortunately, we only have one camera that we will be able to broadcast the game for you. But we want to make sure that you're able to see the game and able to enjoy everything that this game has to bring for you. Kentucky State, they are coming off of a victory against Central State in the shoe in Columbus, Ohio, and they won that game by a score of 20-6 against Central State University. And coming in today, they're looking to see if they can continue with their winning streak by making sure they can go 2-0 against Kentucky Wesleyan. So today we are going to see what the Thoroughbreds can do on this day, and hopefully they will be successful. It's an absolutely gorgeous day. You have some wind blowing, so that means on the field that the football players will be able to get some kind of breeze as they're playing this game. And I tell you what, being an old school guy, they're playing old school music. And so guess what? I'm enjoying this. But more than anything else, we want to be able to welcome you to the game. So right now, we're just waiting on the start of the game. The game will be starting at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And right now, this is the home opener for Kentucky State. And right now, we're waiting for the players to enter the field. And I believe right now they're holding back on the Kentucky Wesleyan Panthers. I can see them sticking their heads out of the door. But right now, they have not let them out of the corral just yet. So zooms in and zoom out. So right now, we're just waiting to see when the referees are going to let them out and what's going to happen from there. But I tell you what, it's a beautiful day, so we're expecting to see a great football game. The one thing that Kentucky State brings to the field is in 2019, they had a very prolific, and I do mean prolific, running game. The passing game was there only when they needed it. And most of the time they use passing, they use a running game in today's setup to divert from passing. But for Kentucky State, you could almost say they use their passing game to divert from their running game. Because everything that they do, they are literally able to just run the ball on whoever they play. And one of the teams, and one of the things that KSU did last year is that KSU was able to defeat two FCS schools last year in 2019. One was Robert Morris, and the other happened to be Jackson State. And they defeated Jackson State in 2019 at the Circle City Classic. And that was one of, that was a very good game that KSU played. And the one thing that I can easily say is they just ran the ball down their throat. And they have not changed their philosophy at all this year. And they are still running the ball. And they essentially, and having a chance to talk to Coach Jackson, that was the one thing that they did again this year against Central State. And when Central State played Kentucky State, they continued to run and run and run and run. And so we'll see what type of action we're going to get from KSU again this year. We see the captains are on the field for the Panthers. And we're waiting on the captains, and I can see now the captains are entering the field for Kentucky State. And so, as you can see, here they are. They are coming on the field, and they will get ready to go to the 50-yard line for the coin toss.
Our captains for today, Kentucky State number 13, Jalen Myers. Number 3, Rick Steph. Number 20, Antoine Lloyd. And number 56, Earl Dorris Jr.
It's the last.
Our captains for Kentucky Wesleyan.
So they've just let the Panthers out.
Number 57, Karis Washington. Number 7, Jalen Humphrey. Number 2, Chauncey Greer. And number 55, R.J. Wilson. Your referees for today.
And here they go. Here comes KSU as they are entering the field right now.
And now.
There they are, led by Coach Jackson. And there they are. So there are your Kentucky State Thoroughbreds coming onto the field.
Along with head coach Charlie Jackson.
And so we now have the center of the field. So now we have the players on the center of the field. And they are doing their coin toss right now. The band is juicing it up, as you can hear right now.
Have a
Okay. Had to step away from the mic. But we'll be ready for the kickoff in a couple of minutes here. Okay, well, as you can see, Kentucky State is going to be kicking off, which means they will be getting the ball during the second half.
Back deep for the Panthers.
And the Panthers will be receiving the ball.
Picking out for the Thoroughbreds. Hill.
And so we are waiting on the 1 o'clock kickoff time. And the wind is blowing the ball off the tee right now. So we have a KSU player that's holding the ball on the tee just to make sure it doesn't fall off again. And here we go. And there's the kickoff. And it's going to be a touchback for the Panthers of Kentucky Wesleyan. So Kentucky Wesleyan will, the Panthers will take the ball on the 25-yard line. And I do apologize to everyone, but I don't have any stats. So I won't be able to give you any of the players and their position as we watch the game. But we'll be able to follow the game and be able to go from there. So the Panthers have the ball on the 25-yard line. It's first and 10. Quick slant pass and incomplete.
Pass incomplete.
So Panthers will have the ball second and 10 on the 25.
Second and 10.
As you can see, what they're trying to do a quick slant because Kentucky State has a pretty stout defense, and they showed that quite well, and they're doing the same thing, but a great tackle right there with a complete pass, but guess what? It was a loss of 5 yards on the play. And so that brings up third and, well, let's just say third and 13 here. But that was a great tackle, great defensive play. They smelled it out, and the defense just rose to the occasion. So now the Panthers have the ball at the 22-yard line. Quarterback goes in shotgun motion. And another complete pass, but guess what? The Panthers are moving backwards, and that's a great thing for KSU fans. And that was another loss. And so far, on their first three plays, the Panthers have a negative 5 yards.
For the third place, number three, Sam.
So KSU is back to receive the punt, and the Panthers are preparing to punt the ball to KSU. Oh, and he shanked it. And the That means KSU is going to have a very short field to work with. And that puts the ball at about the 35-yard lines of the Panthers. It looked like it was a little bit better, but the referees put it at the 35-yard lines of Kentucky Wesleyan. So, here we go. KSU with the ball on the Panthers' 35-yard line. First and 10.
Ball on the 35-yard line.
Thoroughbreds enter the offense enters the field now for their first offensive play. Quarterback is under center, and of course, running play, but no gain. So it'll be second and 10 from the 35-yard line. We're expecting to get quite a bit of running here for this particular game. And we'll see them shuffle in and out quite a few players just to make sure that they keep them fresh. And we'll see whether or not they have a passing game. I can see number 9 out here for KSU. He's out there all by himself. But guess what? Oh, and that was a loss on the play. He was going to pitch the ball out on a quarterback keeper, but he decided to hold on to the ball just to make sure he did not risk fumbling. So that was actually a good decision for him. And right now we have a 3rd and 11 on the 36-yard line. Currently, neither team has moved the ball at all. And between the two teams, we have a negative 6, negative 6 yards between the two. And here comes, tripped up. He was getting ready to try to find his wideout that was going sprinting down the field, but he was tripped up, and the ball is on the 38-yard line.
Bring up a fourth down.
So it's 4th and 13. Let's see what the Thoroughbreds are going to do. It appears they're going to punt, but they decided to bring the players back to the sideline. So don't know if they actually called a timeout or not. Delay of game. They intentionally decided to go ahead and have a delay of game. However, the penalty has been declined, and they want to make sure that the ball is where it is in order for the Panthers to receive the ball at least on the 25-yard line.
Number 4, back deep for the Panthers, David Flores.
So back to punt, we have the Thoroughbreds, and back to receive, we have number 3 for the Panthers. And they receive the ball, 1st and 10 on the 14-yard line. So 1st and 10 for the Panthers on the 14-yard line. And we'll take a quick timeout. Well, maybe we won't. We'll go straight into play. Okay, quarterback goes back to pass. Great catch! One-handed catch.
Robbins pass.
By number two, and that brings up a 1st and 10 on the 29-yard line. Great one-handed catch, and had not had a shoestring tackle, he may have gotten a few more yards if not taking it to the house. First and 10, Panthers. Handoff up the middle. And it is stifled again. Gain of almost 2 yards.
On the defense for the third.
That'll be second and 8.
Number 21, Jalen Johnson. Plays on the second down. Following a 31-yard line.
So second and 8 here for the Panthers. Quarterbacks in shotgun position. Had 3 wide. Oh, tip drill! Interception by the Thoroughbreds. And the Thoroughbreds take the ball on the Panthers' side of the field, and the ball is on the 42-yard line. Anytime the ball is tipped in the air, it's always, always open for the defense to pick the ball off. And guess what? That's exactly what they did. We have 9 minutes and 45 seconds left in the first quarter, and the Thoroughbreds will have their second offensive possession on the 42-yard line of the Panthers. Quarterback goes under, is getting ready to go in the center. As he barks out the plays. Hands the ball off, and there he goes up the middle. Look like he did a gain of 5 yards. Maybe even 6.
On the defense, number 9, Zach Thornton.
So that should bring up.
Brings up a second down.
Second down. Looks like second and 5. 5 yards to go here. Ball is on the 37-yard line. Great run up the middle on the second possession. The one thing about Kentucky State is that they are very methodical in their play calling and also what they do. Handed the ball up the middle again. After the dust settled, it looked like it was a 2 yard gain again. This brings up 1 yard gain, so this brings up 3rd and 4.
On the defense, number 78, Kofer. Brings up a 3rd down.
Now we have a 3rd and 4. Ball on the 36-yard line of the Panthers. Thoroughbreds break the huddle. Pitch out to the outside. Oh.
Ball came from Thoroughbreds.
Ball is close. Very close to a first down. And guess what? The referee said move the chains. So it's a first down. So first and 10 on the 32-yard line. Moved the ball right down to the chains. Had it not been for the Panthers defensive guy that the running back rolled over the top of, he may have not made it. It probably would have been a great stop by the Panthers.
Following a 32-yard line.
But great hard running by the Thoroughbreds. Ooh. Great tackle. Much as I hate to say it, but tackle for loss. Tackle for loss, and it's pushed the ball back to the 37-yard line. Loss of 5 on the play. 2nd and 15. It's a beautiful day out here. Nice sunshiny day. So hopefully everybody's enjoying everything that they're seeing out here. Quarterback keeper. He's got a little room. Oh. Defense grabbed him by the ankles. But guess what? Almost down. Oh, yes, it is. And it is a first down for the Thoroughbreds. First and 10 on the 21-yard line.
Gives us another Thoroughbreds touchdown.
Fans are starting to chant and get into the game. So that's a great thing here.
First and 10, following the 20-yard.
Quarterback goes back to pass. And guess what? He catches the ball and touchdown. Touchdown, Thoroughbreds. Great pass. As I said, when the Thoroughbreds pass, they very rarely pass the ball. But when they pass, oh my gosh, it seems like they're always successful. I can remember one game in particular is that when they actually passed the ball against Jackson State, almost every pass was complete. Hence the reason why they were able to keep them off balance and beat the second FCS team. And here, the Thoroughbreds strike first. As they prepare for the PAT. PAT is up, and it is good. So the Thoroughbreds lead the game by a score of 7-0 over the Panthers of Kentucky Wesleyan.
Kentucky State University.
And I will take a timeout, see if I can get some stats here for you. Just really just taking it out, and they are really going good. So here we have the kickoff here, and the Panthers are taking the ball, and great tackle here. And so the defense, wow, they're really hitting, and they're hitting hard. And so the Panthers will take the ball, and they'll have it on the 23-yard line. So quarterback Roberts hands the ball off for no gain. Loss of one on the play. And that was Chauncey Greer. That had a loss of one on the play. And actually, they just said no gain. So second and 10. Oh, high snap. Oh. He bounces the ball to the outside, and he's got a first down. So first and 10 for the Panthers, and that was an 11-yard run by Dillard. He didn't have any room up the middle, bounced the ball to the outside, and was able to pick up that first down. So first and 10 for the Panthers on the 34-yard line. Roberts goes back to pass. finds a player available. Oh, sidesteps to KSU Thoroughbred and ran the ball for another first down. So first and 10, and that was McGuire on the reception for the Panthers here. And they're starting to find some room here to move the ball. First and 10. Now they're finally in Thoroughbred territory, and the ball is on the 43-yard line. Roberts in the shotgun position. Moving Greer to the other side of the field, and also his other receivers. Three wide to the right side. And Greer sidesteps another player. And he gains 8 on the play. Second and 10. Second and 2.
And the defense from Thoroughbreds, Barry, number 7.
Another high snap. Oh! And he is wide open.
Touchdown. That was a mango.
Wide open and touchdown Panthers. The quarterback knew he was going to take a hit. He took that hit, made the pass, and was completed for a touchdown. And the person on the touchdown was David Florence. And that was a touchdown play. And now the Panthers are set for the PAT. And the PAT is good. So now the score is tied. 7-7. Well, that was a heck of a play right there, I can easily say, for the quarterback, because he knew he was going to take a shot. And because he knew he was going to take a shot, he stayed in the pocket long enough to get that play completed. And once he got that play, and once he passed the ball, he took a heavy shot. But he passed it, made it complete for a touchdown. KSU now is entering the field to receive the kickoff. The band is trying to liven up the crowd here as we wait on the kickoff. But the one thing a lot of people don't like is to have the band playing while the ball is in action. Kicker Mangold kicks the ball off, and it falls out of bounds. That's a penalty, and it is going to be in favor of the Thoroughbreds. And that will bring the ball all the way up to the 35-yard line.
Free kick out of bounds. Ball be placed at the 35-yard line. First down.
So first and 10 for the Thoroughbreds at the 35-yard line. First and 10, Thoroughbreds, 35-yard line. Quarterback tries to go around the corner. Gets tripped up for a gain of 1. And that just brings up a gain of one. Ball is at the 36. Quarterback does an underhanded pass. Pass was complete. Puts the ball at the 41-yard line. So that brings up a third and four. So third and four now for the Thoroughbreds. Jalen Myers goes under center. And, oh, he fumbles the ball. And the Panthers pick up the ball, and they have possession on the 41-yard line of KSU. So first and 10 for the Panthers. Now they have a short field to work with. This game has already been filled with a couple of turnovers for each team. Or should I say one turnover for each team, and hopefully for the Thoroughbreds, the Panthers are unable to capitalize on the turnover. But it's first and 10 for the Panthers on the Thoroughbreds 41-yard line. Throw the pass, swing out, and and it's going to be a penalty on the play. And that was David Florence on the reception. Pass from Roberts for the Panthers, but we're going to wait to see what the penalty is, and it appears it's going to be on K-State.
Who gained on the tackle?
Or did they pick it up?
Face mask. Yep. Defense.
Personal foul.
15-yard penalty. Automatic first down. Number 3 is allowed to remain in the ball game due to the helmet foul.
Okay, so we have a personal foul. And handoff up the middle. Seems like KSU has a slight weakness that the Panthers are trying to exploit here. Four on the game.
For the third, Eldridge Godfrey, the third, plays the second.
Have a second and six on the play for the Panthers. Ball is on the 15-yard line. And hand the ball off right up the middle. And running back plows right up the middle again for another 4 yards, gain of four.
On the defense.
And that was Dillard again as he plowed right up the middle. And that brings up third and one. Make it third and two with the ball on the 11-yard line. Quarterback Roberts is in the shotgun position. Does a quick pass out to the slot, and he does not make the first down. Great defensive play.
On the defense for the third, Hugh.
And that puts the ball now at the 13-yard line. Loss of two. Brings up a fourth down. Fourth and four. To go for the first down, and it appears that the Panthers will go for a field goal.
Man goal.
Be a 29-yard field goal. So man goal will prepare to kick a field goal here, a 29-yarder. Well, actually a 30-yarder. and he misses. The score remains 7-7.
Left in the first quarter, Kentucky State University.
And we have
Kentucky Wesleyan 7.
17.6 seconds. Well, I believe that's 17.6 seconds left. I can hardly see the scoreboard here.
Thoroughbred fans, join us next Saturday, September 18th.
But very little time left in the first quarter, for sure.
University football takes on the Tennessee
and the Thoroughbreds will take over from the 20-yard line.
/TSUTigers.com/tickets.
Thoroughbreds come up to the line of scrimmage. From the 20-yard line. Run up the middle. But they called the ball down. It was a fumble on the play, but it was not before he was down. Brings up a 2nd and 6.
Ball carrier number 12, Jackson.
And this is the end of the first quarter with Kentucky State and Kentucky Wesleyan tied at the end of the first quarter, 7-7. And we're going to have a timeout here as we listen to the band play. Back. I don't know if you can hear me. Okay, now you can probably hear me. The band is finished playing. And it's 1st and 10, Thoroughbreds on the 30-yard line. 1st and 10 on the 30. And pass to the outside. And
pass
is complete. And the ball is now on the 37-yard line. So 2nd and 3. 2nd and 3 now for, and that pass was from Myers. Completed pass. As I said, when they pass, they very rarely pass. But when they do pass, they're very successful. Ball up the middle. No gain. As a matter of fact, he may have lost a yard.
Ball carrier, Conway.
Christopher Conway on the run. And as a matter of fact, they said that he had no gain. Fortunately, they did not have a loss on the play. brings up third and three to go for the first down. Myers getting ready to go under center for the Thoroughbred. Ooh. That was almost a disaster for Myers. He was trying to pitch the ball to the outside, but that play was smoked out by the Panthers, and he had nowhere to go, so he had to keep the ball to make sure he did not lose it. Now it's fourth and five.
Number four, Jonathan Warren.
And now they are back to punt now. And Jonathan Ward is back to punt for the Thoroughbreds. Gets off a great punt. And the Thoroughbreds down the ball at the 32-yard line. Panthers will take the ball at the 32. And it will be first and 10 for Kentucky Wesleyan. Thoroughbreds are already, their defense is already on the field. The Panthers are huddled as they prepare to bring their offense back on the team, back on the field.
Brings up a first and 10, ball on a 32-yard line.
It appears we have a new quarterback. Number 19. And guess what? It made no, never mind. The defense rose to the occasion. They scoped out the play. And there was a loss of four on the play. Brings up a second and 14.
Jeremiah Owens. Loss on the play. Brings up a second down. Now on the 29-yard line.
So we have Christian Arambide on the play. Oh, and he had a receiver that was wide open. Actually hit him right in the hands, unfortunately. Bobbled the ball and dropped it. Third and 14. That was great for the Thoroughbreds because had he caught the ball, what would have happened is he would have had enough room to complete the first down. But fortunately, he didn't make it. Third and 14 now for the Panthers. High snap. Oh, and through the hands again. And that was through the hands of McGuire. Brings up a fourth and 14 now for the Panthers.
Back deep for the Thoroughbreds.
Looks like it's going to be a defensive struggle here today. And we'll see whether or not the Thoroughbreds will come out on top. But the Thoroughbreds have always been a great defensive team. They held, as I mentioned, they held the Central State to only 6 points last week. And we will see here, we have a kick and pick the ball up at the 32, and he's got an open field. And he breaks the tackle and he's off to the races and he's caught. Great run down to the 27-yard line of the Panthers. So that will bring up a first and 10 at the 23-yard line. Great run. Great run. By Brett. And of course, there's the block in the back. Unfortunately, all for naught. And the ball is being brought back And the penalty is going to be marked off from the spot of the foul. And that will put the ball at the 23-yard line of the Panthers. That will negate a great run. And I do mean that was a great run by the Thoroughbreds right there. But unfortunately, penalty on the play. Thoroughbreds right now are in the huddle. And now the team is coming on to the field. Oh, and he swings to the outside. He has some room. He's got the first down, and he brings the ball out to the 37, 38-yard line. And that was number 15, Miles Holmes. And so it is a first down for the Thoroughbred. But we have a flag on the play. Let's see what it is. And from the way it appears, it's going to be against.
Don't let a play as a first down. After the play, personal foul on this Sandy Ruffman. Defense number 44, 15-yard penalty to the end of the run. First down.
And as you heard, there was a personal foul on the Panthers. 15-yard mark off against the Panthers, and that brings the ball to the 48-yard line of the Panthers. First and 10. Thoroughbreds, and they have marched the ball back into Panther territory. Myers gets ready to go in the center. Let's see what Jalen is going to call up. Quarterback keeper. Oh, and he's caught from behind.
Lines on the keeper. On the defense, number four, Kirk.
Shedrick Kirk for the defense on the tackle. Brings up second and 11. Loss of one on the play. As soon as the Thoroughbreds get the legs under them, unfortunately, they get stopped. But we'll see whether or not they are able to capitalize here because they do have a prolific running game. Ball is handed off up the middle. And ball carrier number 32 is Anthony Usher. And great run up the middle. That brings up third and four on the play.
Brings up a third down. Ball on the 42.
Ball is now on the 42-yard line of the Panthers. And we shall see if they are able to get that first down. Myers back to pass. Has a player open. And that is number 2, Jordan Level. First and 10 on the play. Ball is on the 31-yard line of the Panthers. But we have a player that is down for the Panthers, and that is Alexander, freshman. So it's going to be an official's timeout here on the field. We have a player down, and since we have an official's timeout on the field, I'll take a timeout here. And the band is not going to get up to play. I wanted to see if the band was playing, and they're not going to get up. So we're going to take a quick timeout here as well.
Thank you. this month?
Yeah.
You already played?
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
Okay, so we're back here. There's a flag on the play. Let's see what it's all about. Don't know if it's a false start or... Yep, false start.
Offense, number 61, 5-yard penalty, first down.
So we have a false start on number 61. And that is Keaton Davis. Still a first and still a first down, but it's first and 15 here. Myers gets ready to go in the center. Hands the ball. Oh, quarterback keeper pitches the ball out. The number 15, and that was Otis Odom.
On the defense, Jackson.
I'm sorry. We have two of them. Don't know if that was Odom. Humes. So I apologize here. We have two guys with the same number here for Kentucky State. Either way.
What number was it? No, but I'll find out for you.
Okay, and sorry about that. I was trying to find out who that was, but we have... Handoff by number to number three. That was Brett.
On the defense.
That brings up third down and 8 on the play.
Brings up a third down, ball on the 29-yard line.
Yes, ball is on the 29-yard line, and it seems like there is a timeout on the field. And there is a timeout on the field.
First charge timeout of the half.
And the timeout goes to Kentucky State. So Kentucky State, for the remainder of the set first half, they have... Two timeouts remaining. Trying to make sure that they get a first down on the play to continue this drive. Their kicker may not have the leg to make a field goal from this distance.
And the latest edition of the KSU History Book. Email advancement.
If they didn't gain any more yards, you're looking at roughly about a 47-yarder for the Thoroughbreds if they didn't gain any yards and if they decided to go for a field goal. But we'll see whether or not they're successful one way or the other in the next few minutes. 47, 48-yarder if they were to attempt the field goal, that is. Okay. Myers hand the ball. Oh, wide open. And he completes the pass. Quarterback pass the ball off. And it was from Johnson to level. And that was a trick play that worked for the Thoroughbred. So first and 10 on the 3-yard line. Should I say first and goal? I said first and 10. You can't get 10 yards out of 3 yards left if you're on the 3-yard line of the opposing team. First and goal on the 3-yard line for the Thoroughbred. Myers is under center. Hands the ball off. No gain. As a matter of fact, there was a loss on the play. So Selv was met by a host of Panthers. Brings up second and goal at the 4-yard line. Shuffling in players That's Lovell coming back into the game. And he goes wide to the left side of the field. Myers goes under center. Quarterback keeper. And he scores. So Myers on a quarterback keeper. Well, the only problem is, I guess you had the referee on the other side of the field to give the touchdown. I didn't see any refs say it was a touchdown. But guess what? Touchdown Thoroughbred. If they don't give him that from crossing the goal line and being 2 yards deep, I don't know what's a touchdown. But as you can see, the Thoroughbreds are preparing to kick their PAT. And PAT is up. And it is good. Thoroughbreds now lead the game by a score of 14-7. And there's a total of 5 minutes and 27 seconds left in the second quarter. And the Thoroughbreds are on top of this game by a score of 14-7. Congratulations and to the Thoroughbreds just now on that score. Game is kind of going back and forth, but the Thoroughbreds have been in the lead so far in the game. And we'll see whether or not they can maintain the lead in the game.
Kick it out for Thoroughbreds.
Thoroughbreds are getting ready to kick the ball off. And we have on the kickoff, we have KO for the Thoroughbred. And to return the ball, we have Warner. And I can't see the number of the other player. And that is number 88 as he grabs the ball. And there's a flag on the play. And that was Freeman that brought the ball up to the 25-yard line. But we do have a flag on the play. So let's see what the flag is. Ref is on the 42-yard line. Most of the time, what we have is an illegal block. But we'll wait to see what the actual flag is. Oh, personal foul on the Panthers. And that brings the ball, and that pushes the ball back down to the 17-yard line. Panthers will go first and 10 from the 13-yard line. First and 10 for the Panthers on the 13-yard line. And as a matter of fact, I have the athletic director, the interim athletic director, that will be coming in to join me in a couple of minutes. And what I will do is make sure I give him the headsets so he can come to you live. And a great defensive play here. Great defensive play.
Number 14, Daniel Brown.
So right now, this is brings up a third down, third and 9. For the Panthers. And we will have the athletic director for the Thoroughbreds coming up at the beginning of the third quarter. But we have 4 minutes and 37 seconds left. Oh, great, great pass. Oh, my God. Caught him in stride. But he stepped out of bounds. But that was a great pass by Christian Arambide to Florence. Great pass play. And that brings the ball to, and he stepped out of bounds at the 49-yard line. I'm sorry, make that the 48-yard line. That was a great pass play from Arambide to Florence. Great play, at least for Kentucky Wesleyan. And second pass was complete for 2 yards. Brings up second and eight.
Number 56, Darrell Norris Jr.
Great defensive play.
Brings up a second down on the 46-yard line.
And that was Darrell Dorris. Darrell Dorris Jr. happened to be a freshman. Great freshman play. Great open tackle play as well. Arambide goes back. Swing pass out to Florence again. I'm sorry, to Greer.
Greer on the defense for the Thoroughbred.
That was Greer on the completion. Brings up third down. Third down and six.
Ball on the 44-yard line.
Ball is on the 44-yard line. With six to go for the first down. Arambide, the quarterback, goes back to pass, but guess what? Great tackle for loss. Absolutely great tackle for loss.
Number 42.
And that was number 42. And his name is Rodney Davison Jr. Great play. Great tackle for loss. And this brings up a punting situation for the Panthers. And this brings the ball to the 50-yard line. Back deep for the Thoroughbred, we have Brett South. So let's see what we have here. Ball is kicked short. And it finally bounces out of bounds at the 10-yard line.
The Thoroughbreds
will take the ball first and 10 at the 10-yard line. With 2 minutes and 15 seconds left in the first quarter. So first and 10 for the Thoroughbreds at the 10.
First and 10, ball on the 10-yard line.
Unfortunately, I have to take a quick break, but I shall return in a few minutes, and we'll have no one on headsets at the moment, but I shall return. I may not return until the first half is over, but you'll at least still have the game up.
ladies and gentlemen, speaking state for the halftime show, the baddest band in the land.
With a big bit and a full coat.
Second, George Simon on the half. Kentucky Wesleyan.
Brings up a third down, ball on the 1 yard line. For the Panthers, Warner. Punt for the Thoroughbreds, number 4, Warner. The punt is down. First and 10, ball on the 40-yard line. Thank you. interception by number 36. Tavis McCain. Correction, number 36, Trevon Pope.
Second charge timeout of the half, Kentucky State. Kentucky State University would like to recognize our 135th anniversary partner, B.L.O.C.K, for their support this year. At the end of the game, grab a complimentary custom KSU B.L.O.C.K drink to satisfy your thirst. Thank you, B.L.O.C.K, for making our 135th one to remember.
Second down, ball on the 15-yard line. Pass and give me for level. Incomplete. Brings up a third down.
Sounds about right.
I guess what we did.
Okay.
Okay.
When's Circle City? Are you going to the Tennessee game?
No.
Next week.
Where is it?
Tennessee State.
Third and final timeout and a half. Kentucky State. Clock operator, please restore the clock to 3 seconds. 3 seconds on the game clock. Thank you.
Who are you playing? Benedict? No.
Yes.
Oh. gonna find out by number 15 for you too. I should go down there and catch them before they leave. Oh yeah.
Okay, we are back, and only just a couple of seconds left in the first half, and the Thoroughbreds are going for a field goal, and it will be a 30-yarder. Kick is up, and the kick is good. So the Thoroughbreds go into halftime with a score of 17-7.
At the end of the second quarter.
Congratulations, Thoroughbreds. And so now we are going to go live to show the marching band and make sure we give you a full feel.
I know we haven't been a little while.
Wow. Well, you heard it live. The Kentucky State Thoroughbred Band, marching band. What a great performance. And they really brought it home in the end. You're watching the Kentucky State Thoroughbreds take on the Kentucky Wesleyan Panthers. The score at half is 17-7. And we will take a break. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, but I can't hear you through here.
Can you hear me now?
No, sir.
Well, I can hear you. What about now?
No, sir. Can you hear me?
Hey, I can hear you.
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Okay, good, 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 good.
If you could turn it up just a tad.
How about that?
That's perfect.
Awesome. Well, good afternoon, and we're here for the getting ready to kick off for the third quarter. And I have with me, I have the interim athletic director for Kentucky State. And let me go ahead and take my mask off here. The one thing that I can say is that we both have been vaccinated.
Yes, absolutely.
And then not only that, but Mr. Ramon Johnson, being the athletic director for Kentucky State, he happens to be the part of a great fraternity.
Absolutely.
And I'm just a little biased, just a little biased here, people. And I'm quite sure you know exactly who I'm talking about. And that's, you can't see it, but Phi Beta Sigma. As far as we're concerned, it's the greatest fraternity in all the land.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Mr.
Yes,
Johnson,
sir.
Great to meet you.
Yep, pleasure meeting you as well.
And as a matter of fact, I'm going to let you have the floor and tell us about Kentucky State and the great things that Kentucky State is bringing to the fans, the alums, and everyone that's here to watch this home opener.
Well, so first of all, thank you. I'd just like to say today is Frankfurt Day here on, at the school that's on top of the hill. And what we're doing is we're embracing the community. This is an opportunity for the university and the community to come together in unison under the big umbrella of college football. We're having an outstanding game. Our Thoroughbreds are currently leading 17-7,
yeah.
As we're approaching the third quarter. Just got through looking at an awesome performance by the Marching Thoroughbred Band and just waiting for the end so that we can come away with a victory.
Yes, I tell you what, it's just an absolutely gorgeous day, and everything that the Thoroughbreds have done had a couple of turnovers.
Yes, sir.
But yet
yes.
And still, the Thoroughbreds, they were able to recover from it, and they are coming out so far with a lead going into the third quarter with a score of 17-7. The one thing that the Thoroughbreds are essentially known for is their run game.
Absolutely, absolutely.
However, today they've displayed something that I haven't seen in a few years, and that's the passing game. So can you elaborate on what's been going on here today in terms of having this passing game? This is something that has been quite shocking for me.
Well, I think that our coach does an awesome job of managing his team. It's whatever's needed at that particular point in time. Just because we're, you know, known mostly for our run doesn't mean that we just have one trick in the bag. So we are equipped to pass, as you can see, and we just do what the defense allows us to do. And again, our coaching staff, they do a great job of maintaining and managing what's going on during the football game. Everyone knows that football is a game full of adjustments, and that's what we had to do as a program. We had to adjust. So we were taken outside of our normalcy and able to do some things that the crowd was pretty pleased with. So, again, we did a great job. Coach is doing a great job, and we just hope that we can continue this throughout the end of the third and fourth quarter so we can come away with our first home victory in over 16 months.
And you mentioned the first 16 months. You had the Thoroughbreds had a great showing against Central State last week.
Mm-hmm.
And with that showing, they were able to come out with a victory 20-6. And even though both teams, they hadn't played in over 600 days, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
But yet and still, that really showed what could be done and what they did as a team. And can you elaborate on just that first game
that
the Thoroughbreds played?
The first game was absolutely wonderful in that our young people and the Columbus Classic organization were able to put on the event and actually bring some notoriety to HBCUs. We were able to do it in the city of Columbus and actually had the opportunity to perform on a bigger stage at the Ohio State University. It was a great showing as far as attendance was concerned. We had over 40,000 in attendance.
Oh, wow.
And that's absolutely large for HBCU Classic. Of course, the Ohio State University, the Horseshoe, as they call it, that's a huge stadium. We weren't able to fill it, but we did make a dent in it. I'm sorry, I'm a little distracted. We seem to be doing well on this kickoff return.
Yes.
But back to the Classic for Columbus, it was a great opportunity for our young athletes to have an opportunity to be exposed on such a large stage and in such a record crowd.
Now, you have another big game, actually two big games that are actually coming up. One against Tennessee State, which is taking place next week.
Mm-hmm.
And if I'm not mistaken, that'll be in Nashville.
Yes, sir.
And then you also have another game right after that that'll be played in Indianapolis, Indiana, and that'll be Circle City Classic. So before you go, I don't want you to be too distracted, but can you elaborate on those two games and those big games that the Thoroughbreds will be in?
Again, some wonderful opportunities. As you stated, next week, September the 18th, I'm sorry, yes, September the 18th, we'll be playing with Tennessee State University at Nissan Stadium, which is the stadium that is occupied by the Tennessee Titans. It's not necessarily a classic, but it will be a huge event. A lot of alumni from both Tennessee State University and Kentucky State University will be in attendance, and we hope that we get the fanfare that will come down and support our Thoroughbreds as we try to continue a winning legacy here at Kentucky State University. And right after that event, we have on September the 25th, the Circle City Classic. This will be the seventh year that Kentucky State University has had the opportunity to participate in this classic. We're looking to play Benedict College, in which Benedict has just come off a win over Edward Waters 44-3. So it's going to be an exciting contest.
Wow. I didn't know about that.
Yes, sir.
So they have a pretty decent team. So that means you're going to have your hands full actually for the next 2 weeks.
Yes, sir. Well, we're going to have our hands full this entire season. You know, our Thoroughbreds, we walk around with a chip on our shoulder. We feel that there is something that we have to prove, and we have to prove that as far as college football is concerned,
yes,
Kentucky State University is definitely a force to be reckoned with.
Now, one of the things that you can really hang your hat, and I'll let you go, and we just missed that play, but we were able to see that he was able to catch the ball in bounds, and even though it doesn't bring up a first down. But one of the things that you can truly hang your hat on is that KSU in 2019 defeated two FCS schools, Robert Morris as well as Jackson State. And with that being the case, you kind of have a target on your head. So with that target on your head and your back, we're looking forward to seeing great things from the Thoroughbred in 2021. And I'll let you leave the last word in terms of what we anticipate from the Thoroughbreds for the rest of the game and also for the rest of the season.
Well, what you will see from the Thoroughbreds, the Mighty Thoroughbreds, is a team that's full of grit, that's full of integrity, that's full of that wherewithal that we'll do whatever's necessary to make sure that we are putting our student athletes in the best possible position. Again, our coaching staff They do a wonderful job of managing our team, our student athletes. They have totally bought into what we've asked them to do, from everything from eligibility to just what their conduct should be walking around campus. We think that, you know, our student athletes have the potential to actually be ambassadors of our university and of our program. So with that being said, what you can see from Kentucky State University as we move forward is a team that's destined to be great.
Well, AD, I tell you what, congratulations on putting together a great team. And from everything that I'm seeing out here, they are absolutely wonderful. Much success to you in everything that you do. And not only that, but from a personal point of view, great job, Frat.
All right. Thank
so,
you.
So I'm sorry, guys. I could not let that go, especially with him being a fraternity brother. And as a matter of fact, before I let you go, I also want him to express where he graduated from and also where he pledged.
Okay. Well, as my shirt says, I'm an alumni of Kentucky State University. So this is my third month on the job. So I'm back home, as we would say. And I actually crossed here at Kentucky State University way back in 1992.
And see, I'm an old head. I pledged in fall 84.
Okay.
So that lets you know, yeah, I have a little bit more gray hairs on my head than the AD does. but AD, Ramon, I tell you what, congratulations. Mm-hmm. Much success to you. And from what I see here, you're going to have a successful year.
Well, thank you. And it was a pleasure being on your show.
Hey, no problem. Right. I look forward to seeing you again, and hopefully I get a chance to see you in a couple of other games.
Yes, sir. All right.
God bless.
God bless you.
And that was the AD for Kentucky State. And he is on his way to see the rest of the game. And, oh, my gosh, and here they are. Sorry about missing that play here, but there was a pass play, and it was complete. And that was a first and 10. But first and 10 for the Panthers, and they have a timeout on the field because of an injured player. So, guys, thank you very much. And for A.D. Johnson, that was a great interview that we had. But we right now we have an injured player on the field. And A.D. Ramon Johnson, we thank you. And we look forward to have for him to continue to have a successful year as the Thoroughbreds continue to play. And but as I mentioned, there is a player that's injured on the field, and we just need to make sure that he's okay. And let's go back live to play here. It's first and, should I say, first and goal for the Panthers. Pass play right across the middle. And the ball is incomplete. But they gave him a touchdown. In other words, what they said, he crossed the goal line before he fumbled the ball. You have one ref that says, hey, touchdown, but we also have a flag on the play. So either way.
It's a touchdown. Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense number 56. That 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the kickoff. We'll have a try.
So either way, you have a touchdown for the Panthers.
West Bank goes with a jump to extra point.
So now the score is 17-13 with a pending extra point. And now the score is 17-14. Oh yeah. So with that, the score is 17-14, and the Panthers will be kicking the ball off to the Thoroughbreds. Oh, so let me get the scoreboard back up here for you.
Wide Insurance, Revolution Mortgage, Huntington Bank, leadership who have donated 1886, and board members who've donated 886. Thank you for supporting Kentucky State University. Be a part of the 135th campaign. Visit ksu.edu. Give now.
Back deep for the Thoroughbreds, number 11, Beza. Touchback. The Thoroughbreds will take up on their own 25-yard line. First and 10.
Come on. Ball ran up the middle. First down run.
Ball will kill yourself on the defense, Bird.
Gain of 2 yards.
Brings up a second down. Ball on the 39-yard line.
Second and eight. P. pitch to the outside. Oh, great open field tackle.
Okay, you're welcome.
And that was number 24, McGee. That was a great open field tackle that he made. Had he not made that open field tackle, he would have most definitely gotten the first down. Loss of one on the play. Brings up third and nine. Ball is on the Thoroughbreds 38-yard line. They've had a chance to pull a couple of tricks out the bag. Let's see what they let's see what else they have to pull out here. Pass play. Oh, wide open for first down. Myers pass to number 12, Isaiah Jackson. Great play, hard tackle. And Jackson is going to the sideline, but that was a great play that he made. First down. First and 10 in Panther territory at the 47-yard line. Nice run up the middle.
Ball carry number 32.
And you had ball carry Conway. Number 32. That was Conway.
On the defense for the Panthers.
So great run up the middle for a first down run. And that brings up second and six.
Brings up a second down. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Game is getting a little chippy now.
On the defense, Lopez.
So right now we have a third down, third and six. Myers comes to the center, pitches the ball to the outside. Oh, and have a flag on the play. And ball carrier is Kendon Walker. Unfortunately, he was short of the first down, but we also have a flag on the play. So let's see what the flag is.
Holding. Offense.
And that was a holding.
The penalty declined. Fourth down.
Holding on the offense. And that penalty will be declined. That brings up fourth down. And Kentucky State finally brings out the punt team. It was almost as if they were considering whether or not they were going to punt. Whether or not they were going to go for it. But they decided that, no, let's rethink this. Great punt. Now, ball is going to be placed around about the 10-yard line for the Panthers. It'll be first and 10. And we have 9 minutes and 54 seconds left in the third quarter. with the Thoroughbreds leading by a score of 17-14. The Panthers are hanging around and playing a good game here, mixing it up really nice between pass and run. But they've had a lot more success on their pass plays than anything else. Oh, almost intercepted by number one, Fugate. And it was, he couldn't catch it. It hit him right in the hands. But yet and still, that was a great play. Good now. And this brings up 2nd and 10. Ball on the 10-yard line for the Panthers. They've been letting these players get by with a lot of movement. And that was Greer. Incomplete pass to Greer. He couldn't get a hold of the ball. It hit him right in the hands again. Another player that missed the ball. Hit him right in the hands. As a football player, wow, could not have been a better pass. As a receiver, you should be able to come up with those pass plays. But calling for the Thoroughbreds, I'm glad he missed it. This brings up 3rd and 10, the ball on the 10-yard line. And we'll see whether or not the Thoroughbreds can hold. Back to pass. Oh, and he's caught from the behind. The ball is loose. And at worst case scenario, there will be a safety. And we have one of the Thoroughbreds saying it is a safety. Quarterback was not paying attention to his blind side. So guess what? Thoroughbreds benefit from his mistake. And this makes the score 19-14, Thoroughbreds. The Panthers will get ready to kick off on a kickoff to the Thoroughbreds. Anytime you have a safety, the team that gives up the safety has to kick the ball off to the team that benefits from the 2 points. Panthers will receive, and the score again is 19-14 with 9 minutes and 34 seconds left. I'm sorry, that's 4 minutes and 34 seconds. I'm sorry, from this vantage point, it seemed to be 9, but I apologize. That's 4 minutes and 34 seconds left in the third quarter. And the Panthers are getting ready to kick the ball off to the Thoroughbred. And because the ball is falling off the tee, you have number 88 that's going to hold it. That's Jaden Freeman. For the Panthers, that's going to make sure that the ball doesn't fall off the tee. Thoroughbreds are back deep. Oh, and he does a squib kick. And number, can't quite see that, number 22 for the Thoroughbreds, Shaquan Oliver picks up the ball and downs the ball at the 49-yard line of the Panthers. That brings up a 1st and 10 for the Thoroughbred. The Panthers defense is already on the field. And here comes the Thoroughbred. Myers is still quarterback for the Thoroughbred. And he hands the ball off. Oh, great run. Gain of five. And that was Self. That was actually a great tackle by the Panthers because he had wide open field had it not been for that tackle. This brings up a second down and five on the field. Second and five for the Thoroughbred. Myers going back under center. Brett Selve is right behind him. And this is the quarterback keeper. And he goes up he finds a spot. Oh, my gosh. Great tackle by Kirk's. Shedrick Kirk. Saving tackle. But this is a first down. This is that was a quarterback keeper all the way. And first and 10 on the 30-yard line for the Thoroughbreds. Great quarterback keeper. As I said, the one thing that the Thoroughbreds are known for is that they have a prolific run game. And if they can't hit you one way, they're going to hit you another way. But the one thing that they've introduced today is their passing game.
Ball carrier Self.
And Self is the ball carrier here. And this brings up a second and 10. No gain at all. Calling in the plays from the sideline here.
Second and 10.
And as I said, a second and 10. And you have Jordan Level on the outside. But the ball is pitched to Kendon Walker. And no gain on the play again. This brings up third and 10. So third and 10 for KSU. There's 2 minutes left in the third quarter. Panthers are trailing the game by a score of 14-19. The game is being led by your KSU Thoroughbred. But we have a third and 10. Quarterback keeper finds a wide open receiver. But unfortunately, number 32, Conway, was not able to get around the corner. And that brings up fourth down.
Conway.
Fourth and six.
On the defense, Jackson. Brings up a
fourth down. And let's see whether or not the Thoroughbreds are going to go for it. Yeah, I can hear them saying field goal, all the way up here in the press box. It's going to be a 44-yard field goal attempt. 43-yard field goal attempt. Oh, and no one was ready. Wow. That play was busted from the start.
Really on the field. As the runner's knee was down, ball goes over on that.
Wow. I tell you what, that play was busted from the start. What happened apparently is that the center snapped the ball before anyone was ready. And had it not been for the holder, it really would have been a disaster. But fortunately, the holder was able to catch the ball, and that lets you know, always be ready, always be prepared for what will take place in any game. But the bottom line is you always have to be ready. You always have to be prepared. The kicker was not even ready. But now the ball is turned over on downs. The ball is at the 31-yard line for the Panthers. The ball is handed off up the middle. And you have a gain, maybe 1 yard. He may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. But it appears that there is a flag on the play.
Offside. Defense. Number 8. In the goal with the snap. 5-yard penalty. Remain first down.
And as you can hear, there was a flag on the play. And it was offside on the Thoroughbreds. And this brings up 1st and 5 for the Panthers. 1st and 5 for the Panthers. And you have number 19, Christian Arambite. And he passes, swings the ball out wide, and he goes nowhere. Great defensive play by the Thoroughbred. Great defensive play. He was swarmed by the defense. Clock is still running, and that brings up the end of the third quarter. And with the end of the third quarter, you have the Thoroughbreds leading by a score of 19-14. We have one quarter left, second down, and we shall see if the Thoroughbreds can hold on to their 5-point lead. And we have a timeout on the field, and we'll have a timeout in the stands. Okay, we're back here. Second down, 2nd and 10. Over the head, and there is a flag on the play. Based upon what a flag is, that's always trouble, and this is going to be trouble for the Thoroughbred that normally says it's pass interference or he's a holding, defensive holding. We'll find out which one. Well, you hear, you hear how great that band is playing. The referee had to wait on them to finish up. But as you heard, that was pass interference. And it's actually first down. Should be a first down for them. Handoff up the middle. And that was great run up the middle.
First down, Kentucky Wesleyan.
By Perrin.
Ball on the 41-yard line.
And that's a 1st and 10 on the 41. We'll see what happens from here. And see if the defense for the Thoroughbreds can hold them out of the end zone. 1st and 10. 1st and 10 on the 41. Another handoff to Perrin. And for that handoff, no gain. So 2nd and 10.
second down, ball on the 40-yard line.
Another flag on the play. Oh, ball is thrown up in the air, but guess what? There's another flag on the play.
Pass is incomplete,
but guess what? Let's see what the flag is about. And it seems like it's on the defense again. Offside defense. So this brings up a second and four. Seems like they want to give him some yards here. It's not a good thing. And joining me in the press box, he has been here all along, but as most sports information directors go, he's the hardest working man in show business. And he gets none of the credit for anything that's done. No. Joining me here is Mr. Christian Flowers. So, Mr. Flowers, say hello to the audience out here.
How's it going, everybody? Everybody doing okay? Thank you for tuning in today to watch Kentucky State take on the Kentucky Wesleyans Panthers. It's great to have football back on the hill. We first time in 2 years since 2019.
It's been over 600 days.
Yes, sir. Things are back rolling. You know, we got a good league going right now. And our offense is really versatile right now. You saw a little bit of that play passing in the second quarter. You know, we had zero passing yards in the entire game last time out. So, you know, now you can see the versatility in our game.
Yeah,
you know, there's former coaches on Kentucky Wesleyans staff from Kentucky State. So, you know, we're catching them off guard, and it's really working. But the Panthers are also playing hard on defense as well.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. And now we have a flag on the play. We had a great defensive play just then where one of our players came straight up the middle, and the quarterback just seemed to just throw the ball away. And it appears that it could be grounding. But we have to wait on the referee to get the final word.
Yeah, because it didn't look like it crossed the...
Exactly. It didn't look like it crossed the line of scrimmage.
A little bit behind there.
Yeah. And with that being the case, that should be against the Panthers.
Should push them back.
But they're talking for an awful long time. Let's see what we got.
There is no foul for intentional grounding.
Oh, wow.
The eligible receiver was fouled by the receiving team. Personal foul, blindside block, defense, 15 yard penalty, automatic first down.
Oh, my gosh. So they actually called a penalty against KSU.
And you wouldn't even expect that because that looked straight like an intentional grounding nowhere near.
Exactly. As a matter of fact, I don't think anyone saw that other than the referee. As a matter of fact, Kentucky Wesleyan, they were looking to go backwards themselves.
Yeah, so, and it looks like they're going to talk about it a little bit more. But, yeah, that's an unexpected call right there.
Wow. Well, we'll see whether or not that play is upheld or if someone is seeing something different. That's, wow. Okay, let's see what we got here. Yeah, they're still talking.
Correction. Offsetting penalties on the play. Replay the down. First down.
Okay. Well, that helps a little bit, I guess.
Yeah, it doesn't really give them extra yardage at the same time. But, you know, also they also are in good position right now. It looks like they're on the 32.
First down, ball. Yeah.
So, still first and 10. Oh, up the middle. And that appears to be a gain of 5 on the play. And that was number 12, Dillard, for the Panthers of KW.
On the defense for the Thoroughbreds, Jeremiah Owens.
We were talking earlier to the AD. Oh, great, great pass, but great, even a better tackle.
Yeah,
and that was by number 8, Banks.
Yep, Artest.
Artest Banks.
Yeah, Artest has been really a pivotal player on the Thoroughbreds defense, even at Central State, making plays. He spots the ball really well. So I think he's one of those guys that he's very versatile. He'll rush you. He'll get you past. You know, you're not passing on him.
And that's the one thing that defense, this should be a penalty against the quarterback, because what he's trying to do is draw them off, offside. You're not supposed to make any type of abrupt motions as a quarterback, and that's the one thing that he was doing.
Unless the center snap. Good coverage there by, it looks like, Amani Spinks. The defensive back.
Now we have fourth down, 4th and 3 for the Panthers. Let's see if they plan to go for it or kick a field goal. You have 11 minutes and 44 seconds left in the game, and it'll be interesting to see whether or not they decide to.
It looks like they're going to go for it.
And guess what? You're exactly right. They're going for it. Uh-oh. They're putting their chips in the game right now.
And you know, you only have to gain about 4 yards, so they can go for a quick pass on the inside.
And there it is.
Oh, great play. That was Artest Banks once again, making those big plays on defense. You know, he had a good rush as well. You know, that's what's changing the ball game right here is defense. It's not really a high-scoring game, but both teams are – you know, right there with their defenses.
And this is essentially what won the game for the Thoroughbreds last week against Central State.
Yeah, I mean, it's defense, and that's where you see, you know, their defense is really, really strong.
Mm-hmm.
But what the offense does is it throws them off, too, because if your defense isn't strong with our offense, it's going to throw you off. You know, undisciplined teams have a problem, you know, watching our ball, seeing where it's going to go, don't know what to do. Because
right.
If you don't know where you're supposed to be at, where you're supposed to line up at, you know, we're going to get you because we're going to throw you off. You know, we got wide receivers running the ball like they're running back. So.
And they have done a great job on defense. And the quarterback keeper here. Great defensive stop. Unfortunately, the Myers helmet has come off.
I think he has to leave the game, correct?
Yeah, they're causing him to leave the game because of his helmet coming off.
And it looks like Jonathan Jerry is going to come in, make an appearance today.
And this is his first time in the game as quarterback, correct?
I believe so. I want to don't quote him on that 100%, but I believe his first time in. And, you know, you got to look at Colin, too. He's very versatile. The tight end, number 88, very versatile. Block, runs routes really well. You know, a little sweep to the right. Looks like a little one yard run.
So this brings up 2nd down.
And, you know, but the clock is running. That's the other thing, too. You know, we didn't get a lot of yards, but the clock is continually running and running and running. So, you know, it doesn't hurt. You know, we can get 1 or 2 yards, but we took 30, 40 seconds off the clock every play.
That's right.
So we're going to run it down. So now you're putting the Kentucky Wesleyan Panthers in a predicament to really play speedball, getting that 2-minute drill and try to get it done.
That's right. And now we have 10 minutes and 12 seconds left in the game. 3rd down and 8 yards to go for the Thoroughbreds.
And it's just a timeout. It's like a timeout by
KSU.
Yes, sir. So, you know, I think we got a one possession ball game too, so it's not over. You still got plenty of time.
Yeah, there's plenty of time for this game.
And I think the defenses have proven that this is going to be the defensive win championship type of game.
But the way the Thoroughbreds have been playing, even if they have to punt the ball off back to the Panthers, the Panthers have been very successful on their pass plays. Only on a couple of runs have they been successful. But overall, the defense of the Thoroughbreds, they have really put up a nice wall against the Panthers. They haven't had too much success. They've had a couple plays, But for the most part, they've played great defense being the Thoroughbred.
You know, and I think that has a lot to do with the addition with Coach Brewer. That's kind of his defensive line. You know, he's very disciplined, got his guys doing drills, very meticulous in the way that he does things. And you can see that core is very strong. So that's one thing I think that's very notable about this season compared to last season, is that defensive line is under kind of a new administration, as you would say.
Yeah, new administration. I tell you what, the administration is doing a great job.
Yes, sir.
Now on offense here, we have a 3rd and 8. Myers is on the center. And he pitches the ball to the outside. And it looks to be no gain on the play. He may have lost a yard. And as a matter of fact, he did. He lost a yard on the play. That brings up 4th down. Clock is still running.
Man, they got, 20 seconds to run off the clock as well, too. So it's going to get right there. Yeah,
it's coming
a little
right
over
down.
9 minutes.
It's coming right down to the end.
Oh, great. Good kick to the 40. Looks like Kentucky Wesleyan's number. Well, actually, the Thoroughbred stopped it right there. Looks like on the 32.
Yeah. 36-yard line.
Yeah, 36.
Yeah.
36, yeah, sorry. 36, looking at the thing about the wrong way. 36. So now, you know, the Panthers have to travel a little ways down the field in order to, you know, get this touchdown or even, and they have to get a touchdown. They can't.
They can't kick a field goal.
So they have to score. And if they score, they're taking the lead.
Yeah, and which means with 9 minutes and 11 seconds left in the game, ball's on the 36-yard line. They have to really put together a nice drive. Even if they scored, the one thing is they would only have a 2-point lead if they were to score. And even if they did a 2-point conversion, it would still be in a position for the Thoroughbreds to still be able to at least tie the game.
It looks like, oh, wow, big play by 19. Looks like it's going to be a touchdown.
And guess what?
They fired back on the first play.
On the very first play from scrimmage.
And that was 19 to Christian Ambrose threw a good one to Brendan McGuire. You know, I think that was one of them plays where it can hit you at any time, and it hit us early.
Yeah, and they hit us early and hit us quick. But guess what? That's a good thing.
Time's on our side.
Time is on our side. Because that gives us the time
to run down. To run down, but also, too, if we take 8 minutes or, let's say, the 9 minutes we have left, by the time we run it down, if it takes us 5-6 minutes, you only got 3 minutes.
That's right.
And now you're in your two-minute offense, and I don't see another play like that, you know, popping off that fast. That was a quick one.
That was a quick hit. That was really a quick hit by Kentucky Wesleyan.
And you got to give it down to Brendan McGuire, because that was a nicely run route, too. So
it was. I mean, he.
First charge timeout. The second half. Kentucky Wesleyan.
Yeah, so that was a really good call. But that was one of the things that I was alluding to, that they're passing. That's the only thing that I've seen that has caught the Thoroughbreds off guard. Is the passing from the Panthers. Outside of that, they have stifled them all up and down the field. With that really quick hit right there,
I mean, that was a pretty good hit, too, from the 36.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, I do think our guys got it in them, too, to fight this out right here.
Yeah, they should be able to fight them all. But as I said, what they can do, once they kick this PAT, all we have to do, and we've shown that we can actually move the ball. And once they kick the PAT, the Thoroughbreds get the ball back, we'll see how successful they'll be.
Yep, and you know, I look like they're going to go for 2 on this one. And it looks like he's not going to get it.
And
he's going to get stopped. It looks like, I think that's 34, Dockery, the Eldridge Dockery the third. You know, he'll get them from you know, converting that 2-point conversion.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, so now it's just a 1-point lead. So all we need to do is get down to the 10-yard line, 15-yard line. That's ball game.
That's the ball game.
But we also have to be mindful, too, not to leave, don't do it too fast either.
Yeah, because that quick hit with what they just did, which means it's always in their back pocket where they can actually do the exact same thing again.
Yep.
You're hopeful that the defensive coordinator for the Thoroughbreds, he's got that and he's able to see that, okay, we cannot allow this to happen again. And as long as he's preparing his defensive backs for any potential quick hits, hopefully it won't happen again.
Yeah, we got Brett Silva and Nathaniel Myers Jr. back for the ball as well. But it looks like Brett Seals going to be the main one.
And I tell you what, neither kicker has had much success with the ball on the tee.
Yeah, and it's not even too windy, too, so I don't know what it is.
And there's the kickoff.
Decent kick.
And it goes into the end zone. That brings up first and 10 for the Thoroughbreds, and the ball will be placed on the 25-yard line.
So we're in decent field position starting back. Got the best advantage we can get. I think we showed that we have the pass game with us today as well.
Yeah.
So that's another thing to look at, too, is we might not rush the ball. We might, you know, get after on that passing game.
And as a matter of fact, from someone who's been paying attention to the Thoroughbreds, that has been a huge surprise for me as well, watching the Thoroughbreds come out on passing down, on plays and pass the ball and be successful. And there's a handoff up the middle.
That old school ball, and even for, you know, Brett Silv, he's 5'8", but he runs it like he's 6'2".
He runs hard.
Yeah, very hard.
He really runs hard, and that's the advantage that they have. And here, they gain just 1 yard, so that brings up 2nd and 9.
And just under 8 minutes and 30 seconds left on the clock, too, so you still have that time there. But you at least want to get maybe 4 or 5 yards off this next play.
Yes.
To give you a good position to convert on third down as well.
Myers gets under center. Going for a pass play. Mm. And it's tipped off the hands of number 17 of Foreman. Jimmy Foreman?
Jimmy Foreman. And so that's the thing, too. We have about 20 running backs, but,
gosh,
you know, some of them might be wide receivers, too. And I think that's what makes it so versatile is we got guys in that running back position that can catch the ball. And then we got guys in that running back position that can run the ball.
And once those running backs catch the ball on the outside, if they make a mistake and if the defense makes a mistake and they don't make that open field tackle, they're gone.
Yep.
Myers on the center again. He goes back to pass again. Oh.
Ooh.
Oh, short.
Just short.
But guess what? There's a flag on the play. And from the way it looks, it was a flag.
On Kentucky Wesleyan, I believe.
Yes. It should be against Kentucky Wesleyan. Based upon what a flag is, it's either defensive holding or pass interference. So we'll see what we have here.
Right to the pass. Holding. Defense number 4. 10 yards penalty. Automatic first down.
Thoroughbreds first down. 1st and 10. Moves the ball to the 36-yard line.
And not too much time off the clock either.
Awesome. Have 8 minutes and 1 second left to go in the game.
Oh,
So first and 10 here for the Thoroughbreds. Myers goes back to pass again. He swings the ball out. Swings the ball out to number 15, Otis Odom. And that brings up second and 8. Gain 2 on the play. A lot of running for only 2 yards.
Brings up a second down, ball on the 38-yard line.
Myers going under center again. Pitches the ball out. Face mask. Oh, my gosh.
We got a couple flags.
Yeah, all because I didn't get a chance to see who that was who grabbed.
It looks like Brett or Jordan Level was kind of.
Yeah, but they grabbed that face mask.
Yeah,
that
they
was
did.
Not good. Yeah.
Grabbed the face mask and looked like Jordan got hit kind of late.
Yeah.
On
so
that
we
last
could have.
Play.
So at the very least, 15 yards, but yep. It's going to be a first down.
Yep. So, you know, and that's that undisciplined ball getting Kentucky Wesleyan.
Exactly.
Because all you have to do is be disciplined. You would have stopped with a 2-3 yard run. But now in these last two plays, you put, 25 yards almost, I think?
That's 30? Right. No, you're right, 25 yards.
So, Go ahead. Now we're on the 52, so it's like we're in an even better position.
Yep, and the ball now is on the 45-yard line of the Panthers. First and 10, Thoroughbred. And we have another player coming in. We have Bryant coming in, and he's flanking out far left. Myers is under center, and he's going back to pass again. And he's going deep for Bryant.
Ooh,
and he catches
it. Great play.
Great play. Great play by Bryant. And he just came into the game. Awesome.
You know, and that's another one of those hard-hitting plays, too. You know, put you down the field just like that.
And
that's how easy the game can change.
Oh, wow. That was a great play. Like I said, Kentucky State has been known for their running game, but today they are really showing their offense, breaking out the passing game. First and goal.
No, but we still have to remember too, we got a little bit of time left on the clock as well. We got about 6:09 and running. So if we get in this next minute, that'll give the Panthers about 5 minutes
to
get on the other end of the field.
Right.
You know, and I think our defense shows that they're playing tough, they're playing hard, so they'll be able to hold them, but there's always that time.
It's always that time. I would love to see the Thoroughbreds get a touchdown here, because by them scoring a touchdown, that forces the Panthers to have to score a touchdown. At worst case scenario, the Thoroughbreds can kick a field goal and they would still get the lead.
Yep.
But having a touchdown really puts pressure. Oh, and he got pushed back.
And that red zone D is another thing too. It's a lot harder to make plays shape when you only got about 10 yards to work with.
Exactly.
And you can't move your players around like you want to. So now we're third on the what looks to me the 6-yard line.
Yeah. And that's third down. And that was Brett Self.
Yep.
On that running play. And he lost yardage there. Brings up third and goal on the 6-yard line.
You know, and this is going to be a definitive play of the drive right here. You know, you're inside the 10. You know, you get the option. You're going to run the option again. But what are you going to do? Then throw it out. And
open in the end zone. Great play. Great play right there.
I said earlier, Colin Wegener, you know, he's going to hit you when he hits you. I called it earlier down the field. I said, he's right there. You got to watch out for him because he can block and he can run routes.
And he ran a great route. I mean, just wide open in the end zone. So, touchdown, Thoroughbred. Now, as we were saying, this really puts the pressure back on the Panthers, where they have to score a touchdown. We have now 4 minutes and 41 seconds. That gives, still gives a lot of time to the Panthers. This has been a well-played game. Got several penalties on both teams, especially personal fouls on the Panthers, though. The one thing I know of Coach Jackson, if any of his players get a personal foul, I feel sorry for him.
He's a very disciplined coach when it comes to things. He makes sure his players understand the assignment.
Yes.
And, you know, make sure that they know what play they need to run. If you don't run the play, he'll ask you, why did you run the play?
Exactly.
So when it comes with him, he's very, all his players are very disciplined. They understand everything. So it's just, it's just them, you know, putting it all together.
And that's the one thing I truly like about Coach Jackson. He preaches discipline. He makes sure they understand exactly where they have to be, what they are supposed to do. And as long as they're in position to do everything that they're supposed to do, they do great.
Yeah. But here's the other thing, too. Are we going to go for two on this next play, or are we going to hit the extra point?
Well, I tell you what, they're in the huddle now, and they're talking things over. Knowing Coach Jackson, he has something up his sleeve. What do you think here?
I think if I know my Thoroughbreds right, we're going to go with another option play style, either with a run to the outside left, or we're going to hit – a run up the middle.
And guess what? They're going for two. So let's watch it. What happens here? Pass play again.
To the right. And he got it. He got. Oh.
Oh.
Oh, see.
Almost had it. He almost had the score. But either way,
still a 5-point lead.
Still have a 5-point lead, which still forces them to have to score a touchdown. And we have a timeout on the field with the score 25-20, with your Thoroughbreds leading the game by a score of 5 points with 4 minutes and 39 seconds left in the game. Panthers, as we indicated, will have to score to have any chance of winning this game. But now it's going to come down to the defense that the Thoroughbreds play. As you can hear, the band is trying to make sure that they push the fans up, and they make sure that everybody is up and ready for this game and ready for the final 4 minutes and 39 seconds.
And this is a great matchup against two in-state D2 opponents as well. It's the first time we've seen these guys in almost 2 years, really. I think we defeated them our last time out.
You did?
Yes, so, you know, we know.
And here's the kickoff.
Good kick.
Run back. Oh. Oh, no. He's got an opening. And that was number 88, Jaden Freeman. He's been a slippery guy all day today.
Yeah, and that's the thing, too. You know, you kind of don't know what to expect sometimes. You know, you expect us to run the ball, and we pass the ball.
Yeah.
So, you know, I think it's the same thing with the Panthers, is that, you know, they're either going to pass the ball, they're going to run the ball, but their pass game it seemed to be really good these last couple quarters.
Yes. And so now it's up to the Thoroughbreds defense.
And I think we're a little bit – about a 4-yard shot with that last drive that the Panthers scored off of, too, as well.
Let's make sure that the Thoroughbreds can hold them. Pass play right across the middle. Slant. And that's for a first down.
But it looks like.
And that's number 10. That's McGuire.
And then number Amani Spinks got that tackle, it looks like.
Gotcha.
23.
McGuire's name has been called quite a bit as well.
Now, and I believe he was the same guy that scored on that last drive as well.
I believe he was. All right, defense. Passing play. And there goes McGuire again for another first down.
And, you know, you get that free time to stop the clock by running to that sideline as well. So now you got the clock freed at 4:04.
Yeah.
On the looks like 29-yard line.
Wow.
Or 30, yeah, 29-yard line. You're in good play with 4 minutes left. So, you know, this is where defense win championship saying comes to life.
Yes, it is. First and 10, the ball is on the 29-yard lines of the Thoroughbred. Aaron Byde is back in the shotgun position. Gets the ball. Of course, it's a pass play, and he runs up the middle. And he has an opening, but he's tackled from behind.
And he
gained 9 yards on the play.
Yeah, I think he's just shy. Just shy. That was almost a quick first down attempt, too, by the quarterback. So, you know, he threw the ball twice really well, and then he took it right up your gut for the second play to get right there. What, we're less than a yard for a first down? So,
yeah.
And the clock is barely moving.
Don't say that. Three minutes left in the game.
Oh, bad snap. But they recovered.
Oh, they recovered the ball.
I'm not sure. I think it's shy of the first down.
It's going to be real close.
They might, you know, get out and check that. Our chain game might have to look at that.
Wow, that was real close. Third down.
It's not you.
So third down, handoff. Oh, the quarterback keeper. Oh, and he tripped him up for a first down.
You know, and you kind of see their play call switch up. You know, it's that pass, and you're thinking they're going to run the ball.
Yes.
With the running back, or they're going to do this, but it seems like they just do the basic.
Yes.
You know.
Now it's first and 10 at the 19-yard line.
And you want to credit these runs to the offensive line, the Panther offensive line.
Yes.
Because without their blocking, they wouldn't be able to attack the way they are.
And we have 2 minutes left in the game, but we have a timeout by the Thoroughbreds. 2 minutes and 1 second left in the game. And, of course, we have a timeout right now. They say third and final?
I believe so. That's what it sounded like.
Yep. Panthers, I'm sorry, the Thoroughbreds are out of timeouts.
And the Panthers have two. So you have two timeouts. You're in the red zone. So now you have time. Now you have time because instead of just having four attempts, you have possibly eight attempts to get into the end zone.
Because of those timeouts.
Yes. Because you get a first down. You know, that's another four plays you got for you right there.
Exactly.
And then you got timeouts. So if you don't use them, you know, you can play them last 2 minutes of how you want to play it.
Exactly. And that's exactly what's happening here. And I think that's what Coach Jackson saw. He wanted to take timeout.
Regroup. Quickly regroup.
And with his players regrouping, saying, okay, look, let's just calm down, keep everybody in front of you, and make sure you don't just let somebody slip by. We got three wide on the left side of Aaron Byde. Oh, and he goes.
Oh, whoa. Oh. Incomplete.
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 Great pass breakup. If he had not turned around in time, that was number 23, Oliver. No,
Anthony,
I'm sorry.
Anthony Usher. 33 for us, or 32.
Number 32?
Oh, that's Amani Spinks again.
That was Spinks. Great pass breakup there.
And he's that guy I told you about earlier. You know, he can get you in the rush, but he can cover the ball, cover the receiver fairly well.
And here's the – come on.
Oh, got caught up.
Ooh. Okay, so now this brings up a third down. Ball will be placed on the 17-yard line. And this brings up third and seven.
You know, and the fans are doing a real well job, too. Now, along with the band and the KSU fans, you know, the noise is here.
Yes. Oh, and they added time back on the clock.
With
bringing time back up to 144.
About 14 seconds, right?
No, gave them an additional, it was 38.
38, okay. Yeah. But, you know, every second counts.
Yeah.
Every second counts.
And we don't want to add any more time on the clock.
And they still have one timeout. You know, they have a little ways to work to get this first down.
Yeah. What is it, third down?
Yep. But, I mean, they, you know, let the clock run down here, get the play in, let the clock run down. You kick a field goal. Now K-State has under a minute left to even come back.
Yeah.
So now you put
But if they kick a field goal, that means they have to kick an onside kick.
Oh, true. True, they do have to score. So they don't have a choice but to go for it.
So let's see what we got here. Third down. Aaron Byde is back to
Wide
open.
Touchdown.
And it's a touchdown.
Wow.
And that was number six. That was Peters. Peyton Peters.
And he was covered. He was in double covers and made a catch.
Yeah. He threw the ball up, and he was able to come down with it.
But it's players like that, when it counts, you know, and it hurts. It stings.
Yeah, it does. That really stung.
But we only lost 4 seconds off that clock, too.
Good.
So we're at 137 right now, so we still have time.
So actually, putting the time on the clock
helped us.
And with that, with a minute and 30 seconds, they're going for two again? Yes, they're going for 2 points again. We got three wide. He goes into motion. Hand off up the middle, and he did not make it. So excellent defense again.
And that's the same thing with the defensive line. You know, with the Coach Brewer, new administration comes in, they're locking it down.
Yeah.
You're not going to run up the gut like that.
And you know what? Had we not gone for two, this game would be tied.
Yeah.
Wow.
It would be.
Maybe it's me. I'm not hitting the court, though.
No, it's something here.
Oh, I see. For all the latest news, Kentucky State University Athletics, visit our official website, KSUThoroughbreds.com, and follow @KSUAthletics.
Well, KSU fans, we have a minute and 37 seconds left in the game. The score now is Panthers 26, your Thoroughbreds 25. And as I said, we have a minute and 37 seconds left. So, Mr. Flowers, what do you think? What do you think
we're
going
to come
Coach
back.
Jackson is going to do?
I think you're going to see that pass ball come into play quickly, but you're going to see that run, that read option come into play too, to throw them off. Because you're expecting a deep ball, you're expecting us to just throw it down the field, but you know, we're going to run up your gut. And if you got Brett back there, he's going to power it through you. You know what I'm saying? So you have to look at it like that as well. But you also know that we can throw the ball, and we've been pretty effective at it. I think even in the first half, we were 6-for-6 for receiving. Brett still back, runs down to the right, gets through.
He's through.
Is he going all the way?
Great run. He is inside Panther territory at the 35, 34-yard line. Great run back. Now with a minute and 26 seconds left.
So now it's in the kicker's hands.
How many yards do he need? Maybe 10, 15?
I would say maybe 10 at the most. I think he can hit it. If we get to the 20, I think he can hit it.
From here, if they gain not any additional yards, you're talking about a 48-yard field goal attempt.
And I think we can do it. I think we can do it. I think that you know, you're gonna see a quick little option play right here, I believe.
Myers on the center,
right in the middle,
ball off straight up the middle. And that's number three, Sell, Brett Sell. Fans are really into the game. Clock is running with a minute and 12 seconds left in the game. Myers under center again. Hand the ball off straight up the middle. Sell gets the ball down to the 20, near the 20-yard line, almost in the red zone. And this brings up third down. You have a minute left in the game. They are in position at worst-case scenario to kick a field goal.
Yeah. And we're in good territory to kick a field goal.
Oh, and he, ooh, it's going to be close for a first. Oh, they gave him a first down.
Yeah, so we have. It's just stopping the clock, though, too.
Okay, they gave him the first down. So now, 36, 35, 34, 33.
Oh, great. Ooh.
They have no timeouts. 26, 25, 24 seconds left in the game. Okay, the Panthers are taking their time getting up off the ground. 18, 17, 16.
You got to spike the ball here.
You got to spike it.
You just got to spike it.
12, 11, 10. Okay, 10.8 seconds left to go in the game. The fans are on their feet.
And this is going to come down to Gerardo Beza. Our kicker out of Boaz. So, you know, he's kicking fairly well.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, this is going to – when the kicker matters, this is one of them games, too, where it's a clutch play.
Yes.
You know.
And this is where the kicker earns his scholarship.
Yep. and exactly. But, you know, I got faith in him. We got Johnson Ward.
So the ball is on the 25-yard line, so it's going to be a 35-yard kick.
Oh, they tried to ice him.
Yep, they're icing him.
Tried to ice him.
And they're trying to do the exact same thing, force the Thoroughbreds to do the exact same thing that happened the last time that they went for the field goal,
mm-hmm,
when it was just totally botched.
Yep.
Don't understand what happened there. But yep. Here, timeout. They have one more timeout left. Oh, I'm sorry. They have no more timeouts left.
That was their final timeout.
Yes, that was their final timeout of the game, which means the only other way this game could be stopped by the Panthers is if they are offside, but you don't want to be offside, because that means you move the ball closer for the Thoroughbreds. So let's hope that we have a good snap, a good hold, and a good kick.
Everybody's standing up. Everybody's on edge in Alumni Stadium, too.
Kick is up, and the kick is good. The kick is good.
Oh, no.
Oh, he missed it. It was wide left.
Wow.
It was wide left.
Wow.
And it was just wide left.
And it looked good from here.
Yeah, from here, it really did look good. But it was just, and I do mean just wide left.
It was there.
And we have 6.1 seconds left in the game. And all the Panthers have to do is just kneel on the ball. And
that'll be game.
This was a well played, hard fought game. And you have the Panthers over on the visitor side. They're up screaming, saying how great of a game this is and this was. And with time running off the clock,
that's going to be it.
Game is over. And the Panthers of Kentucky Wesleyan steal the game from Kentucky State. And this was a very well-played game, hard-fought game, but Kentucky State ended up not coming out the victors. And with the end of the score, the final score of the game is 26-25.
And, you know, this one of them games where it hurts.
Yeah.
It hurts.
Yeah.
Because you saw life. You saw that that fourth quarter was probably the most energetic quarter of the game.
Yes, it was.
It was back and back. So, but you could see that we wanted it just as much as they wanted it. And you could see that fight go all the way in until the end. So, I mean, these games happen, but, you know, I think we'll put a good show on at Tennessee State. I think that's another game you have to look forward to. You know, it's against a Division I opponent.
Right.
But I still think you see what happened in 2019, how many opponents we beat.
Exactly. Because you actually played two Division I teams. You played Robert Morris.
And then
you played Jackson State
yep.
in Circle City Classic.
Yep.
And you ended up defeating each team.
Yep. And so that's the thing I think you have to look at. So, you know, you're gonna have a tough time. I think, you know, new coaching, and I think that'll be playing to our advantage too,
mm-hmm.
is that,
mm-hmm.
you know, these players had almost 2 or 3 years to play with one another, and now down there at Tennessee State, this is their first year with a new head coach.
Yes.
And I'm curious to see how that game with Jackson State is going to play out, because that'll really tell you where they're at.
Exactly.
That'll really tell you if they're there or if they're still working out the kinks.
Because I know during the summer I had a chance to watch Grambling play against Jackson State, and Grambling was still putting things together. Grambling did not win a game during the spring of the year.
Mm-hmm.
And they were really having some issues. They ended up changing their OC. But they ended up defeating Tennessee State by a score of 16-10. And Jackson State defeated Florida A&M by a score of 7-6 last week in the Orange Blossom Classic. And with Tennessee State playing Jackson State tonight at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, it'll be interesting to see whether or not Tennessee State has a decent defense and they can hang with Jackson State, or if they defeat Jackson State, that really says a lot about how well they can play, and the Thoroughbreds will really have their hands full in that game next weekend. So right now, we have the alma mater being played by the KSU band. But the bottom line is that the game was well played. And even though we did not win the game, the Thoroughbreds did not win the game, the one thing I can easily say is that everything that they showed is that they really showed a lot of spirit. They showed a lot of fight in the team. The one thing I do know that Coach Jackson will do is that he will take a look at the footage. He will take a look at the film and say, okay, let's make these corrections here. Let's see the things that we need to do to make these changes. And once he gets out and talks to his players and his and all of the coaches review this film and the footage, he's going to make some decisions and make some changes and make some updates. Because as you saw from what he did from last week to this week, the passing game was really took center stage.
Yeah, and I think that's something that you gotta be expected for now. Is, you know, that passing game is there, and I think that passing game is what really made a difference.
It really did.
Really did, is because the rushing wasn't there. But I just want to thank you. I have to sign out and continue my SID duties for the rest of the day. So I want to thank you for coming out and streaming the game, and, you know, just showing what K-State has to offer. Show us our brand new field, first game in Alumni Stadium, streamed on our brand new field here at Kentucky State. So I think that's one thing to take note is we're back. K-State football is back. Single game tickets are on sale. Tennessee State Classic tickets are on sale now. You can find them at TSUTigers.com, or you can go on KSUThoroughbreds.com/tickets, and you'll be able to find everything. You'll be able to find everything there. You know, we're going to do a group package deal for tickets to catch the remainder of the home games. Dudes out here doing backflips in the middle of the things, I'll be right and take care of that. So
And I have to agree with that. So, Christian, thank you for being here, and thank you for taking your time But, yes, we need to get those. So Mr. Flowers is going to take care of those other players trying to turn backflips on the logo of the Thoroughbreds, which is something that we're not going to have. But bottom line is first home game on the new field for Kentucky State. And even though it was unsuccessful, the one thing that you did see was that Kentucky State did put on a good show with the passing game. The running game, as he said, was not there. But the one thing that was there was that the passing game did take center stage. And with that, I will be signing off. And for our post-game show, Coach Jackson is already gone in, so we'll see if we can get him. But we'll have him on Monday at 12 noon on Block Sports. If you want to hear Coach Jackson live, watch Block Sports. The show initially starts at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on yourstreet.tv. And Coach Jackson will come on with his show at 12 noon on Block Sports. And we look forward to seeing you then. And we are going to sign off. But thank you very much for listening to yourstreet.tv and with the Block Sports football show of Kentucky State versus Kentucky Wesleyan, with the final score being Kentucky State 25, Kentucky Wesleyan 26. Until next week, until Monday, God bless, and see you next time.